Disasters aren't just big things like earthquakes and hurricanes. When it comes to disaster recovery, more often we're looking at brownouts and broken pipes. Floods, fires, common software or network failures. Relatively little stuff that can add up to big problems for your organization if you're not prepared. So you need a plan. Start by deciding if a secondary data center or a cloud-based disaster recovery as a service solution, also known as DRaaS, makes the most sense for your business continuity plan. If you opt for a secondary data center, you'll need to build and maintain the infrastructure, as well as complete a required annual test of your disaster recovery plan. On the other hand, DRaaS requires no capital expense, and the annual test and failover are completed by the provider, saving you capital, time, and resources. Like other as-a-service models, it helps to offload time-intensive tasks and management responsibilities to a trusted partner. And one partner I highly recommend is Peak 10. They were the first to achieve a Cisco-powered DRaaS certification. This requires regular and ongoing audits to ensure stringent industry best practices are being met. Peak 10's offering is fully managed and brings continual data protection along with the fastest recovery time and recovery objectives in the market. The recovery platform is backed by 5 nines of availability and a service level agreement for recovery time objectives, and we'll help you choose the solution that best meets your needs and budget. From an essentials plan that includes continuous data protection and meets a recovery time objective of 8 hours, to a premium plan for the most demanding workloads that features dedicated compute, all flash storage, support for large virtual machines, and meets a recovery time objective of 2 hours. No matter your choice, you'll be well prepared in the event of a disaster, whether it's a powerful storm or a run-of-the-mill power outage. To learn more, visit cdw.com/managed services.